What's going on, folks?
It's me,
Mikey Pipes. Friday, love me Fridays. Friday, July 4th, 2025. It's a quarter to 12 here in the great state of New York. Going on an emergency residential air conditioning service call. Homeowner just called about 20 minutes ago saying, hey, Mikey Pipes, it's blown out warm and it's 79 degrees in this zone. I'm like, I got you. Let's go take care of it. Sorry, doggies. How are you, sir?
So yeah, you have like a remote control on holidays. This thing goes off Sundays, holidays.
I know. If that was the case, it would have been about an hour before, because I would have been out already, and then I would be hitting your head with a massive trip charge.
Thank you. So this is the
zone.
So you replaced the entire system.
I too. Yeah.
The other one is relatively new.
Okay.
That's working.
That's good, even though there's no maintenance that we have done, at least.
Yeah. Nothing. Yeah, nobody else touches my system except for you.
Don't forget, annual maintenance don't look like that.
I know. I really should do that. I even had you guys do a boiler once.
So
that's just
the filter's clean?
Yeah, I every 2 months. I know it's early. I do like every... I go crazy about this one. Why not do it?
74, and it's 79.
I think it's cooler outside than it is inside.
Yeah. Went out,
get
a walk, you know, get a cup of coffee, came back, and
was
like, what the hell's going on?
Oh, you got a Bosch. Nice.
No, that night. You probably don't remember. So, COVID. It was right after COVID happened, and he said to me, I said, I don't need a battery. The fan, you know, it's high end. He goes, well, the choice is Bosch installed in 24 hours, or the regular system you want in 3 months. In 2 months, they go into COVID. So I'm like, so I tell everybody, I have one of the top.
We did it during COVID.
Systems.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
It was literally right during the whole thing when you couldn't get any stuff. So,
correct.
I said, I have a great system. I spent $7,000 more than I wanted to. I didn't want it. It was 24 hours, and it was, you remember, it was horrible to get our supplies back then.
Here's the other one.
Yeah, so this is the one that's...
blazing hot to the touch.
Yeah.
Woo!
Ow.
That is fire!
So, and it's not going,
no,
so...
it's not going.
Okay. Oh.
That's not... That's a problem.
Yeah.
That's a big problem. That's really a big problem.
Well, how about someone go outside
and
you let me know when it turns off.
Okay. Well, so how do I know?
Well, the other one's going to turn off, and then we'll turn that one back on. Oh, can I hear you from here?
So you think it's one thing on, it's one for both units?
No, you have multiple breakers
right,
here, but
saying, right,
we're going to, I'll turn one off, and you'll let me know if that Bosch turns off. What do we think? Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. All right, I killed power at the upper breaker. The Bosch is still running. Got my tools. Let's go see if I got the right
look
one.
Look at your videos. Not bad.
Not too shabby.
Not too shabby, huh? A little extra, you know, stuff comes in there with the ads. This is, you get some good views, man.
Thank you. All right. Maybe we got the right one. Yep. No voltage. Let's check the ground.
He's pretty much the Kim Kardashian of what he's saying.
I wouldn't say that. Nothing. 40 over
5. And debris is gone.
She's blazing hot. Let's cool her off.
Okay, to turn on?
Yep. Compressor's in a blanket. Is it on fully?
Yeah.
Okay. Gotta cool it off. Blazing hot, thermal overload. Nailed it. I could do better. Nailed it. Titan HD 40 over 5.
I want a little bit of passer. I know nothing about that, to be honest. But
so your system not only overheated,
yeah,
and had everything shut down in thermal overload,
right,
primarily, well, because the capacitor died. So the 9-volt battery in your kid's toy,
yeah,
is no longer doing anything, and your kid is screaming at you. Yeah. You know the feeling.
Yeah.
It probably fused together because of
the heat?
Excess amperage, probably.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
July 4th.
Purple with two reds on common, brown on fan, yellows on perm.
All right, gonna turn the power on, hope for the best. I'm lazy, hopefully that works.
All right, you ready? All right, take the water off.
All right, now we wait and see if it starts displacing heat outside from inside. All right, outdoor ambient, it's around 80 degrees. I'm not even getting like a consistent air moving here, by the way. Like it's coming in spurts. That's how dirty and messed up this coil is. Discharge of almost
93 degrees.
As a comparison, the Bosch around 94.
Here, I'll do a little social experiment.
Yeah.
Put your hand here. How's it feel?
Feels great.
All right. Put your hand here. Well, up a little bit higher. How does that feel?
Warmer.
Like where's, yeah, but you feel the difference? Like, yeah, the air is not moving.
Yeah.
Yeah, this unit is like done.
Yeah.
So like you can't even, like the coil can't even be clean because look at it.
It's literally
flaking away. So the reason why it's not coming up with a steady intensity,
right, like
is it's even right here. It comes like in spurts, like a
I
pulse.
I feel it here, then I feel it there.
Yeah. So because the coil is so dirty, it's literally not sucking the air across the coil through it. But you are discharging almost 100 degrees of heat,
yeah,
from inside the house outside. So it is working, but
realistically, rather than
realistically, you know, you're gonna have to bite the bullet and replace,
yeah,
it.
So
it soon.
So okay, I don't remember, you know, this is gonna be
it's working.
Yeah.
But out plan,
yeah,
and budget accordingly. I'm not saying it's gonna die tomorrow. It could.
Yeah.
It could,
right,
you know,
right,
listen,
right,
it overheated.
Right.
The reason why nothing was working and it was blazing hot to the touch because it overheated because the 9-volt battery for the toy wasn't doing it, but the toy still wanted to run.
Right.
Right? So you luckily, you know, if it's going to die, it's going to die within the next 24 hours.
Right.
So the motor, the internal windings on the motor could have burnt out, and or the compressor.
Right.
But listen, it is cooler now.
Yeah, but
it's still hot.
It's still hot.
But listen, it's 104 degrees. What do you think? It's not gonna be cool.
I don't feel any heat on this one.
It's off. All right, folks. Another satisfied customer. I want to play a game, a little contest. The contest will pay out a poster. Someone's going to win a poster in this contest. The person who gets closest without going over, guessing the service call invoice total before tax, is going to win a free poster, regardless of where you live in the world. Even if you live in West Bumblefuck, like West Africa or Antarctica, I will send you a poster, the closest without going over. All right? And I'm not going to respond to every single one, but I'm going to respond to the winner. All right? I'm going to pin your comment, so beware of scammers out there. All right? There's a lot of scammers who are going to impersonate me and say they're Mikey Pipes Pipe Doctor, right? But I will be able to pin the winner a week from, you know what, next Friday. During Free Friday, next week, a week from today, I am going to announce the winner on the live stream of the Uncensored channel, and then I'm going to pin the comment. And unless you're the account owner, like me, you won't be able to pin the comment. So if someone's out there asking you, oh, you're a winner, send postage money here. No, no, no. Postage is included, folks. Everything is free. The postage and the poster, closest without going over it. Total value of the service call without tax. Okay? Thanks for watching. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.